చేసేసా. చెప్టర్ నెంబర్ 4, లిట్ లో లీ, లిట్ లో లీ, హెరిటేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా. బై ద వర్డ్ ఇట్స్ లిటరీ, యూ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎనీ హౌ రిలేటెడ్ టు లిటరేచర్. లిటరేచర్ ఇస్ ఎన్ రిటన్ డాక్యుమెంట్స్, ఓకే. ఇట్ కుడ్ బి అ స్టోరీ, ఇట్ కుడ్ బి అ పోయమ్, ఇట్ కుడ్ బి అ స్టాన్జా, ఆర్ ఎనీథింగ్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఇన్ రిటన్ ఫార్మ్ అండ్ వెరీ వెల్ రిటన్ ఆర్ కన్సిడర్డ్ టు బి లిటరేచర్. Meant to help of expression, symbol, drawing and sound to communicate his thoughts, ideas, feelings and emotions to others. This led to invention of dialect and scripts. These scripts contributed to the overall development of language. Over a period of time, language was being used for expression of thoughts. The constructive use of language led to creation of literature. From the ancient to Indian literature is known as known for its diversity and uniqueness. Indian scholars divided ancient literature into Vedic, classic and classic literature. Besides this, some folk literature was also popular. So folk literature, jena ke lok katha, lok vartha ke yo hue. Classical literature, alright, Vedic literature. So basically in Vedic literature, there is an information about how to live a life. Classical literature contains stories, while folk literature having the story of the particular place, like a particular village story, particular king's story, something like that. Language and literature. If we quickly look at the history, we can see emergence of various varieties of language since centuries. This language influenced one another and it resulted into development of literature. As a result, some new language and literature have developed and flourished. The best example of this is Sanskrit. Sanskrit language is less in use present time, but religious ceremonies and worship rituals are dealt in Sanskrit language. Nowadays, most of the people who say Sanskrit language is not known. Chhatai, Savarna, Amuk, Shlok, Aapde, Jebholi, Jee. આજે લોર્ડ શિવા માટે હોય કે કૃષ્ણ ભગવાન માટે હોય કે કોઈ ગોડેશ માટે સંક્રાંતિ સ્તુતિ હોય તો આ બધે બધે જે પ્રેયર્સ જે છે એ સંસ્કૃત લેંગ્વેજની અંદર છે. જનરલી લેંગ્વેજ પ્રોવાઈડ ઓપોર્ચ્યુનિટી ફોર ધ હ્યુમન્સ ફોર બેટર એક્સપ્રેશન એન્ડ અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડિંગ. ઇટ્સ મોસ્ટ એન્શિયન્ટ સ્ક્રિપ્ટ ઇઝ ધેટ હેવ બીન સિવિલાઇઝેશન વિચ હેઝ નોટ બીન ડિસકવર્ડ એન્ડ સો વી હેવ not obtain much information about the language. So these languages somehow cannot be related. So there are certain scripts for them. Uru lakhelu ee samay ko pan mayo. But nowadays we don't know what these are. Nowadays we don't know what were the things which is written by them.
કરે કે કોને કહેશું, કેવી રીતે કહેશું, તો એના બેઝિસ ઉપર એની
which is a writing arrangement, typical rhythm, or let's just say poem. It is one full poem divided into 10 divisions. Most of the verses are made of what they were used during temples. Among the verses, those worshipping Usha, that is goddess of Manu, are present. This work describes political, social, and religious matter of Aryans who were residing in the region of Sufism. Since Sanskrit is a language considered to be of the language of Aryans, so this describes all the social, economic, or all the things related to Aryans. Yajurveda. It is called a Veda of Yamas. It composed in both the forms, prose and verses. This describes hymns recited in the time of Yamas, the religious practices and rituals. So it would be in the form of a lesson also, it would be in the form of a poem also. And it describes hymns recited in the time of Yamas. Vedic under Jam Rishi in a hymns Atharva Veda describes various types of rituals and sanskaras. So basically there are 16 sanskaras which should be done throughout a man's life. So these Atharva Veda gives information about these rituals, the tiny rituals that should be done and the sanskaras. Upanishad. The Upanishad literature gives us vivid description and analysis of the beginning of the universe, the mystery of life and life, materialistic and spiritual world. Brihadaranyaka, Nitya, Chandogya are earliest Upanishad in the dialogue form. Dialogue, that means somebody is saying, another one is listening. Or, so it is a kind of chit chat between two people. They are 108 in all, as mentioned in Mukti Book Upanishad. Next is Brahmanika literature. Many Brahmanika epics were composed to understand the meaning of Vedic literature. Any critical appreciation based on Vedas composed in the poem form are included in the Brahmanika literature, Vedic literature, and directly discourse regarding the behavior have been explained properly. So this Brahmanika literature is the one thing it is always in the poem. So anything which is regarding behavior are explained broadly in this particular literature. Aryans, Aryans used to spend their last phase of life in Aryanikas, making their ashrams in Aryanikas or forest. They composed literature based on philosophy, which was the result for their deep thinking. It is known as Aryanikas. Next is Vedangas. The Vedangas literature deals with religious practices and rituals, grammar, astrology, and astronomy. The Ramayana and Mahabharata are two great Indian epics. The present form of this epics can be traced back to the 2nd century. The Ramayana has story of Ramchandra, the king of Ayodhya. Ramayana is a smaller epic than the Mahabharata. It narrates many attractive stories of adventure. The Mahabharata is the world's largest epic. Has 1 lakh verses. This describes the war between Kauravas and Pandavas. This epic also consists numerous stories. The Bhagavad Gita, a part of Mahabharata, expounds the deep philosophical principles. It conveys the message of achieving moksha or salvation through jnana, karma, and bhakti. There is only three ways with adversity. Both the epics, the Ramayana and Mahabharata, have been influenced millions of Indians and the literature for a long time. They have implanted motivational seeds of sanskaras in the Indians. During this period of Sanskrit literature was produced, this contained good combination of religious and worldly aspects of life. The Puranas played an important role in explaining initial Vedic religion of earlier time. During this period, many scriptures, Smriti Granthas were composed. These scriptures dealt with science and philosophy. For example, Kautilya's Arthashastra is a book of management as well as a book on various topics such as art, mathematics, and other sciences. The Smriti Granth has explained the religious teaching, laws, and customs. So, this Kautilya's Arthashastra is basically a way of managing things. Since there was a time or era of kingdom, so the king, how the king should take care of its entire kingdom, what kind of ministers should be there, which type of ministers, which kind of teacher, which kind of someone should be there, and what are the qualities that should be seen in this person. The earlier Buddhist literature was written in Pali, as it is divided into three sections. It is known as Tripitaka. It consists of Sutta Pitaka, Vinaya Pitaka, and Abhidhamma Pitaka. Besides, many other works are also composed in this literature. Gupta period was known as the golden period of growth and development of Sanskrit, poetry, and dramas. The great writers were Kalidas, Bhavagupta, Bhari, Vridhara, Balamurti, Manga, and many others belong to this period. Of these Kalidas is known all over the world. His work Kumar Sambhava, which is a story between Shiva and Parvati and the birth of Kartike and how Kartike kills a demon. Next is Raghuvansham, which is a story of King Ram and his kingdom. So after the Rajyabhishek of King Ram of Ayodhya, Meghadutam, it is a story of love that happened between two persons. And with the help of this love, this couple used to exchange their messages. Abhigyanasamudram, it is a story of a girl named Sakuntala. Since at her birth, to how she is going to meet the king. So after the name of this Sakuntala's child, Bharat, India wants its name Bharat. Rutusanhara is a basically expression of six ritu, which is like Heman, Sisi, Vasant. These all are considered as a ritu, not of the seasons. Are renowned for their best quality and dramatic style. Balamurti, the Kadambari. Kadambari, again a story of Apsara. And Harshchandra, which is a biography of King Harsh. Other works of the period are Bhagavati's Uttarakshatra, Bhairavi's Kirtanchanya. It is a story of Shiva being a party and the fight or wedge between Shiva and the Arjuna. At the end of this war, Arjuna gets defeated and he wants present of certain weapons from the Shiva. Vishakhadatta's Mudraj, Sharduk's Mrichikatika, which is a Martini guy, that means a toy which is made up of clay. Dandi's Das Kumar Charitra. So basically, that in prince of certain king, and he went to 10 different directions. They went in this direction and then they came back to this place and they discussed what are the experience since then they have experienced. The subject of this book were political event, Romans, elegy. There is a story with real meaning, comedies and philosophy. Verses were composed in a real form of Gujarati language in course of time. Gujarati language developed and very literally worked from the coast and the heritage of Gujarati literature was made prosperous by literary contribution of Mercy Mehta, Niravar, Dayanand, Apo, Premchand, Pritam and others who composed beautiful verses, songs, garba, narrative poems, chapas, etc. After that, the scholars like Narvar, Navarma, Kishorelal Mastowar, Panalal Patel, Umashankar Joshi, Mahipatnam, Rupapara, Nilkanth, Gopaldham, Ram Tripathi, others enriched the Gujarati literature through their work. So these were the people who contributed to the Gujarati literature. If you ask your grandparents, they must be known with who Ganga Bhai, who this Akho is, or Tulsidas is. They can explain it to you. The four Dravidian languages, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, and Malayalam, developed their own scripts and literature. Tamil is the oldest of these, with its literature belonging to the early century of Christian era. According to tradition, three literary Dravidian and Sangam were held at which many sages and poets recited their composition. They contain many themes like political wars and love. The famous work of this body of literature includes Itthuta Poem, that means composition of eight poem, Tolka Peeram, which is a grammar book, and Othupattu, which is having 10 songs in it. Othupattu, which is having 10 songs in it. Thiruvallavar wrote the famous Kurai, that is, Kurai means flute. Kurai means flute, which in verse deals with many aspects of life and religion. The Shilpakar, Shilpadikar, which is the jewel anklet, and Manimegala, or nurture in comfort, are some of the most famous work of early Tamil literature. So these were the literature. Out of them, we will try to remember that Tamil is the most ancient language among these other South Indian languages. Okay, that's all for now. Thank you.